So now let's look at an example of sex linkage. Recall that when we say sex linkage, we're talking about an allele carried on the sex chromosomes. Females have two X's, and a male has an X and a Y. But the Y chromosome is much smaller than the X, and therefore has fewer alleles. So one of the examples of sex linkage we talked about earlier was red-green color blindness. And so for red-green color blindness, a female would carry two alleles because she's got a spot for them on both of her X chromosomes, but a male would only have one. So once we know a male's phenotype, we would know the genotype for sex linkage. So we were using a capital C to stand for normal color vision, and a lowercase c to stand for red-green color blindness. And usually the lowercase c is underlined when we draw just so that we can tell the difference between the uppercase and the lowercase. So a female who has normal vision could be homozygous, or she could also be heterozygous, which means she's a carrier of the trait. A colorblind woman would have to have a colorblind allele on each of her X chromosomes, and a male who has normal vision would only have one allele on his X chromosome, and that would be a capital C. If he has colorblindness, he would have a lowercase c, or a colorblind allele on his X chromosome. Recall that males get their X chromosomes from their mothers and their Y chromosomes from their fathers. So let's combine sex linkage with another trait that we know is simple Mendelian inheritance. In humans, dimples are dominant over non-dimples, and red-green color blindness is recessive and sex-linked. A father is heterozygous dimpled and has red-green color blindness, and a mother is heterozygous for both traits. So let's look at their genotypes. The father is heterozygous dimpled, which means he has a dominant allele and a recessive allele, and he has red-green color blindness. Now, since he's a male, we have X and Y chromosomes, and what we'll put on that X chromosome will be a lowercase c, because he has red-green color blindness. Mother is heterozygous for both traits, which means she has a big D and a small d. She has two X chromosomes, and on one of them, she has the dominant allele, and on the second one, she has the recessive allele. So what type of gametes will these parents be able to make? So if we look at the dad, for example, we have to look at every possible combination of the D and a sex chromosome. So he would have a possibility of having the dominant allele for dimples, and he would have an X chromosome in some of his gametes, and that X chromosome would have a lowercase c. He could also have the dimpled allele with the Y chromosome, which would not be carrying an allele for red-green color blindness or for normal color vision. But he could also have a lowercase d because he is heterozygous for dimples, and he could have, with that small d, he could have the recessive allele on his X chromosome, which is the red-green color blindness allele, or he could also have that non-dimpled allele with the Y chromosome. The mom is also going to have every possible combination of d with X. So she would have a D, a big D, with a normal vision allele on her X chromosome. She could have a big D with the same lowercase allele for red-green color blindness. Or she could have a recessive allele for dimples with the normal vision allele on her X chromosome. And she could have the non-dimpled allele with the red-green color blindness allele. So this would mean we would need a 16-box Punnett square. Notice that we've segregated the alleles the same way we would do even if this was not a sex-linked trait. But we use the chromosome so that, we won't be reminded that it's an X or a Y chromosome. So let's put those different gametes that they could make along these boxes. These are from the previous screen. And then for the male, we would put them on the side. It doesn't really matter which side you put them on. So let's take a look at the results. It's a little bit easier to read them already pre-printed. If we look at the top two rows, we will see that these are all daughters. That is because in each one of these boxes, we have two X chromosomes. So these are the daughters. And the bottom two rows are going to be the sons. And that is because in each one of these cases, we see a Y chromosome. So when the question asks you when they have a daughter or when they have a son, what is the chance that, whatever the question is, you will look at the appropriate rows so that you will not be counting all 16. But if we ask the question, what is the chance when they have a child, we would look at all 16 boxes. So if we asked you, what is the chance that they could have a colorblind daughter, we would look at the top two rows only, and you'll see that there are 4 out of 8, and these are shown for you in an orange color. In the case of a colorblind non-dimpled son, there is only 1 out of 8 chance that they would have a child with those, a son with those two traits. So the important thing to remember is that in a sex-linked problem, if we ask for sons or daughters, we only look at those boxes. And if we ask for a child having a particular trait, we look at all 16 boxes.